All right. Just had a sip of green tea, ready to do Rashido. Where is he in V frames? Let me make sure I have all his frame data readily available. Rashid of the Turbulent Wind. Remember the name. This guy's mobility is insane, actually. It might be the best mobility in the game. And it's that a lot of factors that work into that. Most notably, his forward dash is a run rather than a normal forward dash, so you can use it like a normal forward dash, and it goes pretty short distance and recovers pretty fast. But you can also hold it, and get a lot of extra running from that. It ends up being really far, I guess, that he can run. He can pretty much run full screen. It does end after a certain point. Besides that, he has a wall jump as well, and the wall jump is actually special because not only can he jump off the wall, but he can actually fake the jump off the wall and then just jump down. And there are some little tricky shenanigans you can do there that work on everyone the first time. I've never done them, but I've seen them done, so I could theoretically do them, just show them off a little bit. His V skill is very movement based. He's got a couple ways to modify his V skill to be even more movement based. He's got a couple moves that kind of have really good mobility. Like that has insane like it's pretty much impossible to corner this character just because of his really good like presence. I thought that could corpse hop a little easier, but I actually got stuck on Ryu's body. There you go. Let's see here. What do I say about this character? His health is slightly below average, I think. I think he's 950 and 1,000 stun. Yeah, just double checked, that's right. Not that many command normals. Is there anything else about him? About his movement? His walk speed seems to be alright. It doesn't really seem particularly high or low. So range appears to be pretty normal. I don't know if there's differences in throw speed yet. Let's talk normals. He's got an interesting little slew of light normals. The stand short is the only 3-frame normal he has, so it's very common to use that, especially because Rashid has a lot of attacks that leave him kind of minus. It's important to have a really quick normal to stick out if you want to keep the pressure. Even then, that's kind of risky if the opponent's using light normals. I'll get to that, but this is a 3-frame normal. The range is like non-existent, unfortunately. I think you can do some links out of it. Yeah, that would be like a bread and butter, for example. The low short, he can link into low jab or stand jab. I don't think there's a difference. I think one of them he can combo into medium uppercut, and the other one he can't. I just called that uppercut. That appeared to combo from the stand jab. Yeah, there you go. So that's a little bit better because the medium one does a lot more damage than the light. But that's a really inconsistent combo. Like, that did 101. That didn't even combo. It's really fast. There you go. That did 95. So the damage difference isn't super notable. But it is notable that you can do EX. I mean, you can do medium from stand jab, but not crouch jab. Just a difference in frame advantage and whatnot. But those are, like, his only combos from lights that aren't super. His super is very stationary. Even though it's really fast, he has to move into the opponent. I'm talking about a super pretty early, but it's pertinent here. If you're going like into a super from lights, which you often do with like every other character, you'll find that it actually doesn't hit in time. See, like Ryu could block that theoretically if I was smart and had after first attack on. So what you have to do is you have to cancel into the light spinning mixer. And you have to cancel the first hit of that, which only does 20 damage. So you reduce your damage quite a lot, but actually you're increasing it because you can't even do the combo unless you do this. But that's like a bread and butter combo, is crouch, short crouch jab, light, spinning mixer, and then super. That's like how to combo super from lights. Looks like that. And that's the max damage you can get from lights, to my knowledge. Conventionally, so it's good to be ready for combos like that. Let's see here. Yeah, and I should mention as well that a crouching opponent. Yeah, that just whiffs. So do the light one. The light one's better. His crouch short seems to go really far. I think it's 4 frames. I think all his jabs are 4 frames. I think there's nothing tricky about his light normals. Where is crouch light kick? Yeah, they're all 4. And crouch jab, stand jab, and stand short are all plus 4. That's the tightest link he can squeeze out of a, like, that's into a 3-frame move instead of a 4-frame move, so it might have a better chance at interrupting someone or something. I don't know. Less time to reversal out. It's not a huge deal. Oh, that doesn't even cancel. I didn't realize that. Stand short doesn't cancel. Oops. For what it's worth, I did play this character during all the betas quite a lot, and I know a decent amount about him, but I'm not 100% sure. Watch what I do rather than what I say. That's all I'm going to say. If you see it work, then it works. I don't really have that much to say about his light attacks. I don't think there's anything more to it than that. Stand jab is a little better on block than crouch jab. And they all combo into light spinning mixer and absolutely nothing else. Medium punch is really small, but also abnormally fast for a medium button. It's 5 frames. You can link into it from some stuff, most notably Crouch Fierce. It's a very common one. It's got a decent amount of hit stun. You can like go into, I think, medium Eagle's Claw. Eagle's Claw? I'm going to call it Eagle's Claw, I'm pretty sure that's what it is. But you can't go into hard. And then it's also quite for advantage, so you can actually get some links out of it. So that's a really good one. Stand strong low forward. And from there you can get a light Eagle's Claw, which is pretty strong. Pretty useful. Let's see here. What else about it? That kind of combo is really tight, so if you're doing it from the Crouch Fierce, you'll push yourself out of range before you can ever get the hit. And I think that works into EX as well, but we'll get to that. But in general, this is a really good normal for like frame traps. Like that is a +3 move on block into a 5-frame normal. So it takes a really fast button to interrupt that, and that's +3 into a 5-frame normal. So you can catch people with counter hits really easily with Rashid doing strings like that. Not only that, but if you got a counter hit jab, it actually combos from the crouch jab into the stand strong, and then the stand strong again confirms into low forward. That whole little string works. So like you'd be doing that anyway. That would be like your counter hit combo. But then if the jab gets the counter hit, the whole combo works. And if the stand strong gets the counter hit, I think there's some nice things you can do there. Yeah, sweep is a normal one, is a good one. I don't think that works on normal connect though, but it's really easy to react on a counter hit. That's not as high damage as low forward, so combos where you can land the low forward are better, but that works into sweep, but not low forward from that far out. So it depends on the range. Stand forward is like his best poke, maybe. It's like up there. It's probably his best poke. He's got a couple others that I'll mention when they come up. There's no way to combo out of it except cancels to V-trigger. The range is pretty amazing. Again, it hits characters from a range where most characters have nothing that'll hit him. So it's not a super risky button unless you get counter hit, which is not very much of a threat. The damage is not that high. You can actually do empty cancels into trigger with it. That's not a terrible use of trigger, but not a great one. If they walk into the hit, the trigger will hit them, and then from there you can do some juggles and stuff. Something like that, perhaps, would be alright. Let's see here. I don't have that much to say about this move. It's mostly just for winning in footsies against characters that have trouble beating it, and it does go pretty far. Crouch Strong is an anti-air. It might be his best anti-air, not counting Super and EX Spinning Mixer. It's kind of difficult for opponents to beat it. You can cancel it, but... Nice. You can cancel it, but I don't think it cancels to anything useful. Like, I think if you cancel it into something, the opponent can usually beat him before he can actually get the thing out. Like, that. I think the opponent could just reaction uppercut that. Not as good as it looks. But it does look pretty cool. If the opponent isn't ready for it, you can get some free chip damage like that. And most people probably won't be ready for it. I don't know if it works into light. I was using hard there. Medium and light. One of those might be better. That was a lot worse, actually. Medium might work. I'll try it out just to try it. Yeah, that actually looked pretty good. Like, even if they landed and uppercutted, that probably wouldn't hit him in time. So that actually looks pretty obnoxious for a lot of characters to deal with. Catch them in their reset, force them to take some chip. Recovering into the whirlwind. I don't think there's anything else meaningful you can do there. You might be able to get like a down V-skill and get some shenanigans from that. Like a sneaky cross-up or something. I don't know how well that would work, though. I think I would react to that, but I don't know about, like, the general player. Let's see here. Let me leave that on and turn this. That's pretty much low strong in a nutshell. You kind of ignore, apart from its anti-air purposes. It does shrink his hurt box. The damage is okay, but you can't link it to it or anything, to my knowledge. And the cancels aren't super meaningful. You can only go into light Eagle's Claw. Crouch forward is a really nice little poke. Again, you can cancel it to V trigger, and also you can empty cancel it. Oh, I guess they have to be closer. You can empty cancel into light Eagle's Claw, which I think always works. Like if they walk into that, or if you counter poke something, that still combos and it ends up doing pretty good damage. This is in general a very small hurt box on this move. It's kind of hard for to counter poke it, which makes it really obnoxious in pressure, really obnoxious in footsies. Good for Rashid. It's pretty much like a Shoto low forward, except he doesn't really have as good things to do out of it. You can cancel it to Spinning Mixer, and that's really common. It's a 2-block string into Light Spinning Mixer, and Light Spinning Mixer, like, just be aware right now for the rest of this video. Light Spinning Mixer with no mashing is safe. It's minus two. The only thing in the game that punishes that is Zangief's Critical Art. Light Spinning Mixer is super good to end combos with, just because it does a pretty good amount of chip, and if it ever actually works, you can mash it on reaction and get damage anyway. It's not a lot of damage, but you know, the fact that you get a knockdown, you get like a bigger confirm off stuff, and that it's riskless to go for ends up being really strong. This character is basically like a more mobile, like M. Bison, I guess, because you don't have to sit on charge all the time, but he can go for like repeated pressure with safe attacks and then get pretty good damage out of it if it ever works. Let's see here. There aren't a whole lot of safe special moves in this game. I just feel like it's an important factor to consider when playing this character. This guy gets chipped better than most characters in the game. It's kind of a tricky scenario if they block it though, because you are minus two. You don't necessarily want to do that against like a grappler. Being minus two next to a grappler can be really bad. Let's see here. Is that medium normals in a nutshell, apart from the special command normals? Stand Fierce is one of his crush counters. It's also a pretty strong cancel in its own right. You can do Stand Fierce into hard Eagle's Claw, which ends up doing pretty good damage. It also goes pretty far. You can also combat to down B skill into launch, which is usually not that good, but very important in the corner sometimes. Like you can do that into super. I didn't show it off for whatever reason. It's kind of precise. There you go. That's one of his strongest corner juggles. Ends up hurting pretty badly. Like in a whole combo that ends up being pretty strong. And then you can also do, you can just mash out that hit. So that's like that's the way a lot of his corner juggles end. But that little rolly kick move is unsafe. We'll talk about that. That's his V skill, or rather one of them. It's his crush counter though. The crush counter follow-ups are pretty weird. You can walk in and get a hit, which is, I don't know what they intended for the combos to be, but I can tell you some combos that I know work, and then you can form your own opinion on which ones the most useful ones are. You can't really react to it and then cancel it. Like by the time you see the crush counter, it's usually past the cancel window. I don't know. Maybe you could. I'm not 100% sure. You could test really easily by doing counter hit random and then just like working from there and try only canceling it on crush counter. Actually, that looks not too bad. Maybe. Anyway, you can also do some other things with it. It combos into EX at Whirlwind, which seems like it would be really good for combos, and it kind of is because you can cancel the Whirlwind into skill. And the strongest general combo I found with this, using that, is that I was a little. You got to do a late V skill cancel, then an early dive kick. Like that. And that ends up doing pretty good damage. But of course it costs a meter, which is, you know, you'd prefer not to spend that bar. The meterless follow-ups are really kind of bad, honestly. You can't go into hard Whirlwind, which you used to be able to do in the beta. It was really cool when it worked. You can go into light Whirlwind, but that doesn't lead to anything. Same with medium. You can do is like normal cancels, but that's also not too strong. And you can just like, you know, link stuff out of it, which isn't that good either. It ends up being maybe his worst crush counter for like punishing, so it's maybe something you don't really need. Like if you're going for, if you're blocking a Shoryuken and you do something, like it's good in footsies, but if you're blocking a Shoryuken, you probably just want to do like the hard kick instead, because that does a little bit more damage. 108 versus 96. And you have pretty much the same follow-up. I think meterless, you would do that, like, towards strong into hard Eagle Spike. Eagle Spike? Eagle Spike? I'm just gonna look it up on a V-Frames really fast. What's the name of that move? I, like, want to know. Eagle Spike is right. How do I not know the name of a special move that he literally says aloud? Hard Kick. That's probably good for V-Trigger combos, but unfortunately nothing normally combos after Hard Kick. I've seen that combo before, and that ends up being okay. It's not that good. It's okay. Something like that ends up being pretty strong. But that's like a lot of... That's your whole super and your V-Trigger. And it's not even that high damage. I think you can link another Fierce in some contexts. Maybe not. There's one thing that makes it really good, and that's if you're in a corner, it's his much better combo tool. Because you can do a... Alright, let me actually show off why this is weird and why corner makes it better. If you cancel the roll mid-screen, the roll pushes the opponent out of the whirlwind, and then you lose the ability to link anything. In fact, Rashid's quite minus. And if you wait for the entire whirlwind to hit before rolling, which is possible, you also lose the ability to link anything. You need the immediate roll, and you need the entire whirlwind to hit in order to get links like that. But in the corner, the entire whirlwind will hit, and the roll won't push them out of it. So that leaves Rashid quite frame advantage, and you can do combos, something like that, perhaps, would be very common for Rashid. So it's by far his best, crush counter in the corner. You get really strong crush counter combos in the corner, but mid-screen it's very lackluster. If you're gonna do, like, if you got the crush counter mid-screen, if you got it from, like, afar, you'd probably just do, like, I don't honestly know what you'd do from afar. It's, like, a really awkward scenario. I guess you just try and cancel it on reaction. I honestly don't know what he does there. It's like a really... It's like not a scenario where you can easily do stuff. Maybe X. If you got it from close, I think you would just do walk in towards strong at the hard Eagle Spike. I haven't found anything better than that. But if you get in the corner, it's pretty strong. Anyway. In the corner, also to the meterless juggles. Combos, you would do something like in beta he could do that into roll into links, but now that only works into I think stand jab and stand short. Yeah, you can't get like a medium normal there. If you could get stand strong there, it would be so good. I think you just combo to roll. I don't remember. Yeah, that might be all right. I don't know. That's like the one area of my Rashid knowledge that's really kind of lacking. So like, I don't know. Go on YouTube and search like Rashid crush counter combos, but I don't know if there's anything good to go for there. But apart from Stand Fierce as a crush counter, it's also his strongest cancel that's a single hit, but links do more damage. But if you were going to do something like that, it's 80 damage. Like if you were going to do... hold on, let me... This is a good example, I think. Hold on. Does that work? Does that work after this? Alright, never mind. Yeah, links do more damage, so like you probably wouldn't just cancel that as is. You could maybe use an empty cancel into Stand Roundhouse. I mean, not Stand Roundhouse, Roundhouse Eagle Spike, like that. And if you caught a normal, it would be pretty good, I guess. I don't know. Stand Roundhouse, super good. It moves him in a lot. I think it is a low crush, as it appears to be. I'm pretty sure it's unthrowable, but I can't say that for 100% certain. It's only minus 2, so it's safe. It does leave him kind of close, and if it's minus 2 and, like, point blank, that can be a bad situation for him. It is a crush counter as well. The damage is pretty high. The juggles are pretty straightforward. I was actually a little too fast. This little move, the towards strong, it has juggle potential on both hits, and you can just let him both hit, but you can cancel the first one, and that does pretty good damage in juggles. Like, that's a really strong crush counter combo, and you can just react to that. Anytime you get the Stand Roundhouse and the crush counters, that's your juggle, and it does really good damage and has really good corner carry. So this move ends up being one of his most insane moves. That Stand Roundhouse. Really good like screen control. You can kind of just like force the opponent to block a bunch of them. Not in a row though. You'd want maybe like jabs and shorts in between. And it's really nice on counter hit just because it leads to a ton of damage. I think it's neutral on hit. And Rashid does have a 3-frame normal that will be in range, so ends up being pretty good. No, it's actually +2 on hit. I had no idea. So if you hit like a jab or something, you'll beat anything they do unless it's invincible. Pretty useful. So maybe something like and to stand strong. Only a 3-frame normal would trade with that. And even then, I'm not even sure if that would work because of the weird input priority stuff going on in this game. Most every 3-frame normal in the game, I think, is a light normal. And since that's a medium normal, I don't know. There's like weird stuff about trading lights and mediums in this game that might make the medium just win. But I haven't really tested that yet, to be honest. The point is, stand strong is a really good follow-up there. It'll counter-hit stuff that they want to do. And then also you're threatening a throw. Which means it's really bad to eat that Salmon House, even if it's not a counter hit, and it's especially bad to eat it if it's a counter hit. And it's not that bad to have blocked, so it ends up being one of the better pokes in the game. It's also enormous. Startup is bad, but that's not really a huge issue, just because of the range you can use it. Crouch Fierce, I've been using it a bit. This move is pretty strange. It's two hits. Both hits are 40 damage. It's like plus 5, so you can link Stand Strong afterwards. And Stand Strong is a better move to link into. Like, when we were doing Stand Strong Low Forward, max damage ender there is the light Eagle's Talon, or I think EX. I think EX works there. Actually, I don't think it does. It doesn't. But if you get the Crouch Fierce Stand Strong, the Stand Strong combos into medium and EX. So it ends up doing quite a bit more damage. So those are very common punish combos for Rashid. That's like a really good ender for combos. It is two hits, so it can beat some... if you do it meaty, you can beat some attacks that are like one hit of armor, I guess. I don't know how really useful that is. One thing about it that's really weird and good is that if you beat a hit with a move with one hit of armor, this is really strange. A lot of people don't know about this. The first hit causes a counter hit. Is Ryu on? Let me turn him off. If you get the second hit only, it's going to be kind of precise to do. Really precise to do. There you go. If you get the second hit only, it's a crush counter. The second hit of Rashid's Crouch Fierce is a crush counter. So you can space it to get that second hit only, but that's like borderline impossible. I think you can get some links out of that, but I haven't really tested it yet because I only even found out about it a couple days ago. That actually comboed. That was hard Eagle Spike, so there you go. You can just get a reaction combo out of that pretty easily. Pretty weird. And you can theoretically, like, getting a counter hit with the second hit is only possible from breaking armor, I'm pretty sure, or doing it meaty, in which case they're probably not going to be hitting a button on the first frame of wake up, so pretty much breaking armor or bust. You can cancel the first hit of that move, Crouch Fierce. Second hit doesn't cancel except to V-trigger, but first hit cancels into anything, including, like, hard Eagle Spike. I think I was late with the cancel there. Yeah, it works. That doesn't do as much damage as the link, though, but it does work from farther out, which is kind of nice. Like, I wouldn't be able, from that range, to link the Stand Strong. What else about it? Oh, you can link Crouch Forward as well. Like, if you're point blank, Stand Strong works, but if you're not quite point blank, Stand Strong will stop working. But Low Forward will often still work. And Low Forward, you know, in those ranges where you're slightly out of range, Low Forward into Light Spike is better than a Whiffed Stand Strong, so it can be the best ender, depending on the range. And both hits, you can cancel the second hit to V-trigger, so if you're just, like, using this as a poke or something, and you see that it's hitting, you can react by the second hit and cancel the V-trigger. And it combos to V-trigger at all ranges, and then you can get juggles out of that and stuff. Using V-trigger as a damage option is usually, like, only about as good as using it as a, footsie option, though, so I'll talk about that more when we get to V-trigger. Only other normal that's not a command normal is Sweep. It's pretty good. It goes really far. Pretty minus. I don't have a whole lot to say about it. If it gets a crush counter, it's a hard knockdown. It's okay as a poke. You can link into it from a couple things, but in general, it's kind of hard to make it work. It's sort of like notable for its range, but Rashid also has the Stand Forward that goes about the same range. And he also has the Stand Runhouse, which goes farther. And both of those are also safer. So I wouldn't say use Crutch Runhouse that much. It's good to pick up a combo if you get a counter hit. Let's see here. Let me get him back on attack. Hit the block. Command normals, he doesn't have that much. Yeah, good Oki off sweep. That's important to mention. Even if they quick stand, he, like, has decent Oki and decent meaties. Something like that, maybe. I don't know. I'm not 100% sure of that, because I don't normally go for that when I play Rashid. Command normals, he's got an overhead towards Fierce. The range is fantastic for an overhead. The damage is pretty good. The speed is pretty garbage, but it's still fast enough that people might not be able to react to it. And it is airborne, which... Or it's not... I don't think he actually leaves the ground if you hit him. But because he leaves the ground for the animation, there is a little bit of weirdness with attacks in this game. And that thing. We'll get to that. But V-Trigger, there's some wonky stuff you can do with moves that make Rashid airborne. Or even moves that don't. Very particular moves interact in interesting ways with that V-Trigger. And overhead is one of them. Let's see here. There's not much to the overhead. I don't think it's a crush counter or anything. I don't think it's just literally, like, you know, an overhead. Use it to sneak in damage for people who like to low block, which people like to low block against this character. It's -4 on block, so if they blocked it and you were point blank, the opponent would be able to jab you. Apparently it is airborne. I just looked it up on V-Frames. Airborne frames 7 to 20. So if you get hit out of it, you get a reset, which is not that bad. So that's being a pretty good overhead. 23 frame startup, though, that's pretty bad. People can block that overhead on reaction. There's not a lot to say about the move. On counter hit, it's +2, so you can't do anything out of it. This is a super interesting move. Towards strong is his other command normal. It doesn't look like an amazing poke, but it's actually an amazing poke. The range is completely insane. Farther than it looks. And also, it's +2 on hit and only -2 on block. So it's really easy to get someone to like block a couple of these. And it does white damage really fast. It accrues super quickly. And it leaves Rashid point blank. And if it hits, it leaves him point blank at frame advantage. So that ends up being really difficult for the opponent to deal with. And it also works in juggles a lot, but it's surprisingly good as a poke. Like, a lot better than people give it credit for. A lot of people don't really use this as a poke, but it's fantastic. The range at which it picks up punishes is insane. I think it's got 8 frame startup. It's not super fast, but the range at which it works kind of nullifies that. Rashid likes being close, so it's not too bad that it leaves you closer than the stand medium kick. And then if it works, again, stand strong is a super good follow-up because it'll stuff anything the opponent does. And if it doesn't work, you've just got to, you know, block and do a delayed tech maybe or something like that, depending on your opponent. He doesn't have a whole lot of unique attacks, does he? Oh, I guess these are worth mentioning. This is pretty interesting. Okay. So out of his run, he has 2 command normals. If you're holding forward and you hit punch, he does like a little spinning mixer. It's -2. If you do no mashing at all, which does, I think, 4 hits. No, 5. So it's safe. If you do like a little bit of mashing, I think like 2-3 button presses, it ends up being -4, which is still moderately safe, although a good opponent will punish you because they'll be doing light normals anyway, regardless of which version it is. And if you mash it fully, it does 11 hits, decent damage, and is pretty minus on block. There's no way to combo into this running version, to my knowledge. There might be one somewhere with like a really far connect. I'm not really sure about that. But it's a neat little option for like pressure out of the run. And it's safe if it hits for like any of them. Let's see here. You also have a kick follow-up that's like an eagle spike. I think it does more damage. Both of those do more damage than the normal versions, I think. Like, here's the light one, fully mashed. Did 80, and the running one, I think, did like 110 or something. 140. Quite a lot. So they are a bit stronger, but it's hard to use them like that, because there's no way to combo into them, to my knowledge. They are some of the moves that change arcs, I guess, if they go through the, tornado. You can get extra hits and do extra damage. Okay, I thought you could do extra hits and get extra damage. You might have to do it while you're inside the tornado. Some weird stuff going on there. It just makes a move a lot faster, that's for certain. Let me try it with the kick and we'll see if I can get extra damage out of that. Normal one was 140. Also 140. I think it just changes his arc. The tornado also works because it makes them a lot safer. Because if the opponent, say, blocks these, like, they can't easily punish Rashid because they could be getting hit by the tornado with their pokes. Can't counterpoke the tornado. Talk more about that when I get to the V-trigger. Let's see. Special moves. Yeah, I talked about his overhead getting pushed as well. Or, I mean, I'll talk about it more when I get to B-tier. Light spinning mixer is, I would argue, his most important and fundamental special move. Again, because it's safe on block. Three hits of chip damage, 60 damage on hit, and you can also. The way that it works, they do really garbage damage, all of his spinning mixers. But you can mash punches to get more hits, and it doesn't take that much punching to squeeze out all the hits, and they do pretty good damage like that. You should pretty much always mash out the hard one. I don't think there's a reason you would ever not. The medium one, you don't mash out if you're doing the corner juggle to super, otherwise you do. The light one, you don't mash out if it's being blocked, otherwise you do. So in combos where you're not really sure if it's going to hit or not, you can just kind of do it. Like, you can do that on block or hit. And then if it ever, like here's how this works. If the stand strong works, you can do low forward into light eagle spike on reaction. If the stand strong is blocked, you can still do it, but you cancel into that. And if the low forward hits there, you can mash out those hits and get some extra damage. And if the low forward is blocked, then you can just reaction not mash it out, and that whole thing is safe. So he just gets a lot of safe pressure off that confirm. There's a lot of different ways that it can turn out that are all good for Rashid. And again, that combo still works after like a light normal range wise. So if you get a counter, if you start with a jab, it's a frame trap, and also it works on counter hit. So that whole little string just ends up being really obnoxious. Let's see here. EX spinning mixer is his reversal. I think it always mashes itself out. No, never mind. There's a bit of trickiness here. I'll talk about it. On a blocking opponent, you can mash out the medium one, which makes it a lot harder to punish. Which, I mean, it's not great. You should always confirm the medium one, but you can make it really tricky to get a punish because the opponent might like try and chase it down, but you could also just not mash it. It might be able to fool your opponent in a little way, like kind of like again waterfall kick. I'm not even sure if Zangief would be able to chase this down, honestly. But the X one you can't mash out if it is blocked, and I'm also pretty sure it's a crush counter punish, so avoid having it blocked. But it is invincible. It's quite notable that move is invincible. It also does pretty good damage. Let's again get him. Let's get an anti-air going. So this is like his best anti-air in terms of consistency and price. I mean, you might want to do low strong just if you don't want to burn the bar, but like the damage increase from the EX is pretty insane. You could do super as well. That's not bad. And it's also really good for resisting pressure from your opponent. Like, Rashid doesn't have a whole lot of ways out of pressure. So it's good that, like, you know, if you're dealing with a character with a really good mix-up, you can just blow your way out of it if you're lucky. No, that's the only invincibility he has. That and super. So if he's meterless, he has no reversals options. Let's see here. Invincible until active frames, according to this, and it's got 8 frame startup, so good luck linking it from anything. It's not usually worth it to go to that if you want extra damage. He does have an EX move that adds extra damage, which most characters don't. It's good to use Eagle Spike about that. Let's actually talk about Eagle Spike right now. They're all slow as shit. You would only ever cancel into them, to the best of my knowledge. The damage is great. All of them end the combo immediately. I've been showing off the combos into them periodically as I've been playing. That after like a crush counter I was doing. That after a crouch fierce, that's the medium one. That is the light one. Like, combos into mixer are good on block, but they don't do as much damage as those. Like, that did 137, that's pretty weak. 185 is much stronger. Even then, Rashid's damage, even factoring those, is some of the lowest in the game. So you should be ready for that if you're gonna play Rashid. Rashid's damage is pretty bad. But his footsie options are really great, and his pressure is really great, so don't let that dissuade you. Let's see here. The EX one is a combo extender. It works from stand medium punch and any hard normal, and towards medium punch. I don't think he has any other cancels that it works on. Compare the damage of this. Here's Crouch Fierce into stand strong, into medium Eagle Spike. Did 230. It's pretty good. Pretty good damage. And if I want to blow the bar, I get 275. That's a decent increase. It's worth noting that on some characters, you can't do the hard spinning mixer there. You have to use the medium one. The medium one does have better corner carry, but the fact that you're crossing the opponent up means that the corner carry may or may not be something you want. But, like, I think Chun-Li and Kami, maybe some other characters, you have to use the medium one because the hard one just whiffs, so it's good to be aware of that. If you didn't know about that and you're a Rashid player and you do this and it just whiffs, it sucks because the opponent can quick stand and punish you. But that doesn't do quite as much damage. I just did 275. Let's do with the medium one. 260. So it makes it less worth the bar. In the corner, you change sides for that, but in the corner you don't change sides for that, so you don't have to worry about surrendering the corner if you have it. Which is nice for Rashid. It does the same damage too. That's like the most damage you can get out of it. Let's see here. How do I do this? I'll just talk about the next special move. He has this move as an air option as well. It's kind of weird to use. I think he can only use it off forward jumps, even the EX one. So you can't use it as like a fireball punish or something like that, like a neutral. You can't use it like a dive kick. It does pause midair, but it's... I should actually show this off. He recovers kind of far away, but it's also really minus. So when you're going for punishes, you want to walk forward a bit before you go for your ranged punish. Like, Ryu wouldn't be able to get stand strong on block after this, probably, but he would be able to punish it with like a towards fierce maybe, or definitely a walk in low forward would punish it. So you have to kind of go for weird punishes on that, which means Rashid usually doesn't take as much damage from that as like other characters would. And the running one is even safer, or rather it recovers even further away. And the air one, I think, recovers kind of close or far, depending on how it hits. Like, you can hit the foot and then land immediately. But I don't really know how to... I don't know how to space it so that it hits the foot. It's kind of like T-Hawk's Hawk Dive, though. I think. Yeah, there you go. Looks like that. And that, I think that's safe, but it's really hard to space it like that. But look at the range this recovers. That's pretty far. Note that the recovery is giant, though. So, like, if you're fighting an opponent who's fought a Rashid before, he probably knows how to punish that. Oh, yeah, hard spinning mixer. I haven't actually tried that since beta. I don't know if it got better. Let me try that just to see if it works. Hard spinning mixer has no invincibility, but it can get counter hits to function as an anti-air. I think it doesn't hit behind him despite the animation. So you can't use it as like an anti-cross-up. And I think if you do it deep, it'll just lose to air attacks. But it's pretty easy to get counter hits with it just because of how tall it is. So it's not a terrible anti-air. And it does more damage than his low strong anyway. But like, if they did an early air normal, they would hit you. And it's a terrible trade. I just took 90 damage to deal 20. So it ends up being okay, I guess. I think at a highest level of play, the low strong would probably be a little bit better. But hard spinning mixer is still alright. It's like not useless. Really good for fishing for counter hits. What was I going to talk about here? This move is really good after V-trigger juggles. I've been doing hard spinning mixer, which is technically unoptimal, but it's kind of hard to space. He's still on block. It's kind of hard to space this. It requires a little bit of practice. You do a little bit of walking back and then a jump eagle spike, and that's like his highest damage from a V-trigger, conventionally. You can also combat a super, which is the highest damage outright, I think. And there are some really weird precise juggles where you can do an EX, I think, into a ground EX into a ground normal eagle spike. But I don't know if those are even that good. And they're also damn hard to do. Something like that. And then to something from there. But usually the slight walk back into air eagle spike is the strongest ender. Like, that did 296 for that setup. And here's the one I was doing earlier. Hard spinning mixer, 269. Quite a significant loss in damage if you don't use the air dive kick. And just for the record, the air dive kick is a bit stronger than the ground one, I think. Or is it? That did 130. No, I think it's just easier to land. The ground one gets all fucked up by the animation. Like, if you do it too early, he'll just, like, shoot through. Oh, never mind, it doesn't even have juggle potential. So the air one is better. I knew it was, but I didn't know why. But the reason you have to do a little bit of walk back and then do a late dive kick is because it's one of the moves altered by his tornado's arc, which means it's really easy to whiz through the opponent, as well as his jump. So you've got to be kind of precise about this. Different timings based on your setup, but that's ultimately in your control, so you can just practice it. What else? What else about Eagle Spike? That's pretty much it, right? There's not a whole lot to say about that move. It's just a combo ender. I said quite a lot about it, actually. Whirlwind is the only other special move he has, right? Light one is probably the one that's most like a conventional projectile, but you'll note that all of them go up. It's kind of like a weird Gouken medium fireball. It's got a kind of similar arc of effectiveness. It works like a normal fireball up close, but far away it preempts anti-airs. That means you have no presence if you're this far out or further, and the opponent's sticking to the ground. But it's not that hard to tag someone jumping with it. Like, if they jump in and you, as you do it, you can get it as a punish. And then from there, like Gouken, you can get juggles on reaction, which is pretty good. EX Air Eagle Spike is projectile invisible. I should have talked about that. I didn't show the EX one off at all. Thank you. This punishes fireballs pretty well. You can do it really close to the ground. It also does pretty good damage. It does more damage than the normal one. 30 extra damage can be the difference between winning and losing. But it's usually not worth the bar, I feel like. If you're going to do like something like that to the EX one, it works. Trust me. But the damage increase isn't really worth the bar, I feel like, unless it's going to kill. And it does punish fireballs, because you can do it really low to the ground, and just it's projectile invincible, which is really good. Rashid's answers to fireballs are usually his own light fireball, or that, I guess. Yeah, ground EX Eagle Spike into medium spinning mixer and hard spinning mixer, B-Fox. Oh yeah, and it works from B-Skill. It's like literally like the air one. I don't think the version matters, though. I think they're all 130. There's only two versions, the EX and the normal. I'll talk about the B-Skill in a minute. The B-Skill is very strange for this character. Anyway, the Whirlwind. If you catch a jumping opponent with it, you can get a juggle on reaction, usually into Hard Eagle Spike. It's the good one. It also combos to Super, but it's really picky outside the corner, because projectiles do... That's still comboed. It depends on your setup. Like, if I did a... Crutch Fierce into Stand Strong into that, I don't think it would work. Yeah, that didn't even get in range. But that actually works in corners because projectiles do no pushback in corners. And that ends up being pretty strong. That ends up being one of his stronger combos into Super. So it's good to be aware of stuff like that. A little bit, like, that's 60, which is a lot more than the 20 you get from canceling from Spinning Mixer, which also puts you in range. Let's see, what else? Oh yeah, that's actually worth mentioning. Well, I'll get to it. The medium one is two hits and takes a little while to come out. You can still do juggles out of it, you get a mid-air opponent. But just the delay is the main reason to use this. The delay is occasionally really useful. But it's probably the least useful one. The hard one has very similar delay. The arc is a lot worse, but the arc can be kind of useful depending on where your opponent is and where they're going. But notably, the hard one can be canceled into his V-skill. And his V-skill normally goes a certain range. Like, let me get... Backdash, backdash, backdash. See how I stayed in front of Ryu? If I do it from, oh shit, mashing like a scrub. If you do it from a tornado, Rashid moves through the tornado, which alters his arc. So see how I went way faster there? So that's occasionally useful for some stuff. And most notably, if you throw a hard kick tornado from like this far out, and you see someone throw a fireball, you can do the V-skill into dive kick on reaction. And it goes really far as a punish that, like, a lot of people wouldn't be ready for. Into EX, more typically, than normal. That goes really far really fast. I did it later than I needed to. You can catch punishes for fireballs like that. It's kind of crazy. A lot of people don't think Rashid can punish their fireball from that far out. Let's see here. Especially not when he's prior committed to, like, a fucking tornado. The EX one, I showed it off, it also cancels to his V-skills. I should also mention that cancels to his low V-skill too. The EX one also cancels to his V-skills, which is useful for similar reasons. But that one you can use in combos, notably after Crush Counter, because there's no other way to combo into it, I think. They're really slow. It'd be kind of cool if the first hit of Crouch Fierce worked into that. I wish they would do something like that. I don't really think Rashid's low tier though, so I don't know how I'd feel about buffing him. But that kind of combo would be really neat to go for. Like, you sacrifice the damage of your Link combo there, but you get, like, an EX Tornado, which you can then do neat stuff out of. I don't really know that much about where you would use the EX one versus the normal one, barring Crush Counter combos. I don't know if you would ever really use that bar in other scenarios. That's it for special moves, I guess. Alright, this is where things get weird. V skill is a jump forward, and you can do absolutely nothing out of it except a kick follow up, which turns into his air eagle spike. And if you're fighting someone who doesn't know the game yet, you can kind of gimmick them out with a little cross up like that. But realistically, it's kind of hard to use that outside of setups. And a lot of the setups, this is pretty early in the game's development. A lot of the setups aren't well known yet, and the setups that exist and are known aren't well circulated. So, like, there's probably a lot of stuff that he can do with that I don't know. I've seen it used for a couple combos, like that crush counter combo I used earlier, and it's also really good for footsies. It helps him escape the corner, and also if the opponent wants to try and punish it with like a walk-in attack or something like that, you can potentially use the follow-up to hit them out of it. But I think usually this is pretty unsafe, and you can't confirm into it, so you want to avoid that unless you have a purpose that you're trying to serve with it. He's also got a low roll, and the low roll goes through fireballs, at least as of all the betas. I played this guy during all the betas. And that's like his main fireball punish. That is not the right one. Baff in charge of leaving those on. Ta-da! Oh, never mind. I think I have to let it get closer to me. I think that does work. There you go. You can roll under fireballs, and if you're within a certain range, you can not only roll under the fireball, but do a kick follow-up, which punishes the fireball. So basically, Rashid from around here, about this range, has a reaction punish for fireballs. But if he's closer, he can't do it on reaction, and if he's further away, then he won't get the punish. So it's very important to stick around this range if you want to be able to punish fireballs from you. There's no follow-up there, usually, to the best of my knowledge. Last time I checked, there were none, but that was admittedly before release. So I guess I'll try very, very quickly. I don't think there's a follow-up there. In the corner, you do medium spinning mixer, and then you mesh it out. Or hard spinning mixer, rather. You hard spinning mixer and mesh it out, or if you've got a super, you do an unmeshed spinning mixer into super. Those are like the bread and butter follow-ups. I'll show the other one off again, just, you know, to do it. It's really precise to get this one. Thankfully, the input leniency makes it easy. But, like, I think it's like a one frame window and then a. It's like a T frame window twice in a row. Anyway. That's like his main option against anti-airs. I've been showing off a lot of like the little trickier options, but he's got a pretty conventional anti-fireball in his roll. And he's also got his own fireball to contest opponents' fireballs and build some meter on the side. Landing the little kick, or landing. I don't know if whiffing his V things builds meter. That's actually an important question that I really want to find out. Yeah, it doesn't build V meter inherently. Does from landing the dive kick, and probably the EX dive kick. Yeah. And landing the roll for sure builds you a little bit of V meter. So if you want the V meter, you've got to land things like that. Rashid's V trigger is pretty short though, and he can get one or even two V triggers per match comfortably. I mean, obviously he can get one. He could get two comfortably, is what I'm trying to say. V trigger, I guess, would be the next thing to talk about. You can cancel into it like every other V trigger in the game. Unfortunately for Rashid, it's a not an activation. It's like a its own like move. So he can't do like fierce V trigger fierce or something like that. He can't use it to extend combos traditionally. He can only juggle out of it because every hit launches. It does have quite a lot of juggle potential, but it's not infinite. Here's a great example of it not having infinite juggle potential. I shouldn't say it has a lot. It has enough for it to work. And Rashid has trouble making it not work, but here's an example of it not working. I used up one of my juggle potential hits, so one of the hits of the tornado didn't connect. Theoretically, there are setups with that. Like, that sounds ridiculous, but it actually could be good. Where you have, like, juggles out of it, and then the opponent recovers into the tornado while it still has a hit, so they can't do a wake-up attack or something like that. And you can get, like, a safe overhead or things. Trigger does a lot of stuff, and it's all really technical, so I apologize if I leave something out, but like none of the things are really related to each other. It does stop fireballs, but that's not really a huge factor of its use. It does launch the opponent, so you can actually get it to land. You can get combos out of it, which I've been showing periodically, but its main purpose is actually as a footsie tool. If Rashid has something like this tornado hits from the front, obviously. But if I were to like V skill through the tornado, that tornado just hit from the back. If Ryu was trying to down back, if he was trying to just, like, block it, I swapped the blocking direction right before he got hit, and then I would still be able to juggle out of it. Stuff like that is really good for Rashid. So you can use it for ambiguous left-right blocking stuff, but if you're new to Street Fighter and you're not used to this kind of stuff, if the opponent's already blocking one hit, changing the, like, hold on. If I, like, jump over his head while he's blocking it, it doesn't change the block direction. Once you're blocking, you're just stuck blocking. It'll block it automatically for the next hits as long as they're two block strings. But even while you're blocking it, overheads and lows still work. So you can get someone to block it and then sneak in that overhead, or sneak in a sweep or a low forward or something like that, and that's a mix-up the opponent has to react to, and it's pretty tight. I don't think he has an instant overhead of note, so I don't know if you could get, like, a... I think you just have to use this towards Fierce like that. And then I've been showing it off periodically, but his moves change drastically in properties when they pass through the tornado. Like, that V-skill I was using goes really far when it passes the tornado. And then his, I think his fireballs change? No, he can't even throw fireballs. His spinning mixer changes, and his running spinning mixer, and his Eagle's Claw, and his running Eagle's Claw, Eagle Spike. They speed up dramatically. And notably, that does Eagle Spike does quite a lot of chip damage, okay? It just powered up. 150. It did 140 that time. That does power up. I got it. I guess it's the normal ones and not the running ones that power up, and I was just misremembering it. Ugh. Well, whatever. Yeah, you've got a lot of interesting options there because of the way that things, like, change. Not like that. Yeah, the overhead has alarming range. If you go through the V-trigger, like, let's say I want to close out the game, I could theoretically do something like this. Surprise, overhead, motherfucker. You could gimmick someone out like that easily. Even, like, a player who knew the game could get hit by that. It's really surprising to eat an overhead from that far out. It goes, like, three-quarter screen. And it starts at the same... It takes the same number of frames to come out, 23. And it might be hard to recognize as the overhead from that range. And even then, you're safe after that, and the tornado is still following you in, so you still get free pressure afterwards. But in general, if you get the opponent blocking it, like, mixing up between the overhead and the lows is pretty obnoxious, and mixing up between side switches is pretty obnoxious. Oh, the hard kick. I didn't know that one. That one's new to me. Ooh, big. And the roll. I shut off the high V skill, but the low V skill also goes dramatically farther, which means you can punish fireballs from further out. Not a huge factor, but is useful. And then after you land the V trigger, your main combos are the super, the air dive kick, and the hard spinning mixer, depending on where you are on the screen. The super is kind of precise to land. Oh yeah, forward medium. Wait, does that work? Oh, you mean it goes forward farther. Yeah, I should have mentioned that. A lot of his moves go forward farther once he goes through the... A lot of his moves aren't affected, but a lot of them change quite dramatically. Anything where he moves, generally. It just takes a lot of experimentation to find all this stuff. What was I going to say, though? Oh, yeah, getting the super is kind of precise. Like, if you get a combo into V-trigger. I've been showing off this one repeatedly. It's kind of weird to get, like a walk-forward super there. Like, you have to do, like, a lot of walking forward and then a super, and Ryu's kind of flying in the opposite direction, so it's kind of tricky to get. I just got it pretty easily. That's good because it doesn't change the direction, but one thing I like to do that works in almost all setups is I whiff the zooming towards strong. And you just do that as soon as the V-trigger's out. You just hit towards strong. And then you do a super in the opposite direction. And I find that's really reliable. So that's how I've been landing it. I didn't talk about the critical art at all. I normally talk about that before the V-skill. I don't really have my head on straight for these new how to plays for Street Fighter V. I haven't had an order in Street Fighter IV for the V-skill and V-trigger because they didn't exist. Let's see here. The super... I don't know if I have anything else to say about the V-trigger. There's a lot more to say. It's a very technical kind of trigger. You can use it for pressure, you can use it for, like, defense, or, like, getting yourself out of the corner, like, follow it out of the corner, just to have safety. It's safe on block, if you, like, do something like that, just to, like, make a little bit of space. I'll mention his V-reversal. I should have mentioned it for Chun-Li as well, because Chun-Li has a very strange V-reversal. Let me show off Rashid's V-reversal, because it's a bit alarming, if you've never seen it before. I'll block a Shoryuken, I guess, would be fine. Is this a sweep or the Shoryuken? I don't remember. Should be towards plus punches, right? It doesn't hit. It doesn't have a hitbox. He just rolls. It's good for getting on corners and stuff, and also it can make some moves that are normally safe unsafe, depending on how long they elapse. But also you can, like, if it's something... It doesn't necessarily create pressure or freedom from him. Like, he doesn't necessarily... He could be rolling into the corner, potentially. It does reduce his stun like every other reversal in the game, but it doesn't interrupt the opponent's actions. Oh. So it's very strange. It's a really weird reversal. I'm glad whoever told me to demonstrate it. It's good to know that that's maybe a weakness, although sometimes a strength. If someone's trying to chip you out with super, and you're Rashid, not only can you get out of that chip setup with the reversal, but you can actually get a jump in punish on it. Like, it's normally something that would have killed you. You then get a giant punish. And there are some weird specific things that you can get really big punishes on. But I can't say off the top of my head. It's pretty much, yeah, like a KOF guard cancel roll. It's like exactly that, except it takes longer to do, so he ends up being really far out. Let's see here. There was one other... The super. Let me talk about the super. The super is as tall as it looks. It looks giant, because it is. It's a fantastic anti-air for that reason. I've had a lot of success against Vega players where they, like, go flying Barcelona, and they're hanging over my head, and even though they're, like, right at the top of the screen, I still super, and it still catches them. Like, it's huge. It's a fantastic anti-air because it's invincible, and it's actually that tall. And it works straight over his head, too, which is kind of nice. Notably, you can steer it. Let me turn Ryu off recording. So you can move it back or forward. I don't think you would usually move it back except to, like, make yourself slightly safer if you, like, dropped a combo or got a bad confirm. You're like, oops, gotta get out of here. But it's still punishable. But, like, Ryu would want to jump in to punish that, but, like, if you move forward, it would catch his jump in. So, you know, it's like, you can save yourself from a worse punish, maybe, but you can't save yourself from being punishable. And then, yeah, Chun-Li's EX Legs and EX Moonsault from Charlie. That's actually two really good examples. If you alpha counter those, you can get a punish. Thank you for that. Those moves just take a lot of time to elapse, and if Rashid gets out of the way, then he can punish them. Let's see here. The super also, by merit of the fact that you can steer it, it's really good to steer it during combos just to get closer. Like, if you don't steer it, that doesn't combo. But if you do steer it, it does. So it's important to hold towards for a lot of the combos. The steering is pretty minor. It doesn't affect that much. But it's good to know that it's steerable. What else? Is that it? I mean, like, there's more to this character, I feel like, but it's really early, so I can't talk that much about it. Not much to talk about yet. There's this setup, which I talked about and then forgot to ever demonstrate. Shit, the air normals! Why'd no one remind me? There's not a whole lot to say with those air normals. They're very bog standard. Jump jab is a pretty good air-to-air. Jump strong is also a pretty good air-to-air. Jump forward is his cross-up. Jump fierce and jump roundhouse are pretty much interchangeable. Jump roundhouse goes pretty far down, so it's worth mentioning that. I should have talked about them. That was, like, important. Sorry, I forgot about that. But jump medium kick is pretty small, but it does cross up. One thing you can do with it that's kind of gimmicky and good is if you get someone into the corner, like on a knockdown or something, and then jump into the corner yourself, and then jump off the wall with a jump medium kick. Is that the setup? You might have to do it, like, sooner in the... Maybe you have to, like, make a little bit of space. There's some trick there where you can get that to cross up. I think it's just a really low one. Or maybe it's a really early button press. I've never done this, I've just seen it used. But I thought that was the setup. Someone tell me. Is that not it? Oh, maybe you make them block a cross up. That's it. That leaves them a little further out. No. That's too far. Oh, no. That put me at a decent range where it worked. There are setups where you can get a very tricky cross-up that is extremely hard to block. Or even hard to react to. Like, see that? I got it to hit on the front, then I got it to hit on the back. Freudian slip. So you can get really ambiguous jumps if the opponent is hanging around those range, and there are setups that put the opponent at that range. I don't know what they are. Maybe like two light normals. And then it doesn't work, so you go for the cross-up instead. Okay, I didn't actually mean black like a black person. I don't know why I said black. I said black like, I don't know. No reason. Did I stutter? I don't know if I have that much to say about Rashid beyond that. I've, like, talked about everything I can talk about that I know. Combos that you hit a lot are, Sand Strong Low Forward, Light, Eagle Spike, Sand Strong Low Forward into Mixer if it's blocked, Crush Jab, Crush Short Crush Jab into Mixer, and then Mash that if it hits and don't mash it if it's blocked. Safe Pressure Galore, Crouch Fierce, Stand Strong into Medium, Spike, or Stand Strong, or Crouch Fierce, Stand Strong into Light Mixer if it's blocked. Light Mixer in general is just a great way to end combos, but you don't have to go for it. It just does a little bit of chip damage, but it also puts you point blank in minus. So you can dodge mix-ups by never going for it, or you can get chip damage by going for it. So it's all about which one is more important to you. Some characters have really bad like startup on their attacks, so it's like kind of good to end combos like that. And also, if they ever actually work, like if you ever like have that blocked, but then get that to have, be a counter hit, then the fact that you just canceled into that means you can mash it out on reaction, which is nice. Safe Pressure Galore, pretty much. Like, you can just do, like, low forward into light spinning mixer. Oh, yeah, and I've been showing off that, and then just, like, don't mash it on block, and, like, do mash it on hit. I'm slow. It's really quick to do this. What is in the backpack, man? I want to know. But you can also use it as... You can also tick through it like that. His walk speed could maybe stand to be a little bit better, but if you do, like, send light kick, I think that leaves you really close to the opponent. There's something like that. Like that? Yeah, tricky, tricky. Or just even a single light kick is insane as a tick throw setup. Really common there. And then, like, you know, that'd be like another juggle, another combo from a cross-up. Something like that. Versus the light kick into tick throw or even the nothing into tick throw. In general, really good pressure on this character. He's, like, really hard to pin down. You can't corner him. He can zone not that well, decently well, with the tornadoes. And just the fact that he's so hard to approach means he technically can zone forever. Like, no character can really keep him in one place. Just because anytime he wants to get out of the corner, he can maybe do something like that. Or, like, maybe, like, an off-the-wall or something. I don't know. Or just, like, you know, if he gets a knockdown, he can just V-skill over the opponent's head. There's, like, a lot of stuff he can do to avoid being, to resist the opponent's movement pressure. Apart from that, like, his up-close game is pretty good because he has a safe move that he can cancel into. So he can get a lot of damage off chip, but also he has really good frame trap setups because a lot of his normals are really fast. He's got kind of wonky hitboxes in a lot of them, but, just, like, strings like that, or, like, maybe something like that. End up being really good. This is punishable on reaction, but it does work. Is you can do Stand Fierce onto V-Skill. There's like a trick here. I think you can cancel it on reaction. Yeah. That's it. That feels like something they intended. There you go. That's something you can do with Stand Fierce. Use it in footsies, and then if you ever get the crush counter, you cancel into V-Skill and then do the dive kick. Pretty powerful. It's a bit easier than doing that on reaction, although I guess it's slightly less damage. 222 versus 213. Block stringing into that move, the V skill, is like a decent way to get out of the corner, but it is punishable. I'm running out of things to talk about with Rashid. I've talked about pretty much every tool he has. Let me briefly consult V frames to see if there's something I forgot about. I should say right now that Whirlwind Shot is minus point blank. So if you do something like that, it's not just safe pressure, it's minus 7. And let me get a non-counter hit so that we see the actual range it leaves you. Reeve could probably sweep that range. Probably. I just did the one for Chun like right now, Ricky. I'll put it on YouTube. The medium one is minus 4, but it's not a true block string. So like the opponent could shore you can through that. And the hard one, same deal. The hard one is actually safe, though. The hard one's plus 1 on block. So if the opponent didn't interrupt you, that's free chip damage. But, you know, that's a big if. Not getting interrupted. Okay, I browsed all the way to the bottom of his thing here. B-frames. And I didn't find anything I didn't talk about. Are there any other combos? I mean, he's got some counter hit combos, but if you want to see those, you can just go like check out the bread and butter combo video I made, which has all his good counter hit only combos. I'm like really struggling to think of something I didn't show. His critical art is called Altair. Isn't that a star? I literally don't know how to pronounce the name of his V trigger. It's probably like the Arabic word for tornado or something. Yssaar.